Today, I want to read a passage of scripture that's going to be familiar to many of you. It's from the Sermon on the Mount, where in Matthew chapter 6, Jesus speaks about the model prayer, the way we should pray. Matthew chapter 6, I'm going to begin reading at verse 9, where it says this. In this manner, therefore, pray. Again, these are the words of Jesus. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Jesus taught his followers how to give, how to pray, and how to fast in the right way. In this section dealing with prayer, Jesus began by correcting false ideas and practices about prayer. Now, in this part, when we come to verse 9, Jesus gave them a model prayer. He said, "In this manner, therefore, pray." This model prayer begins with the right way to address God, our Father in heaven. You see, the right kind of prayer comes to God as a Father in heaven. It recognizes whom we pray to, beginning with a special title that demonstrates a privileged relationship. In that day, it was unusual for many Jewish people to call God Father because it was considered to be too intimate. One commentator even says that there is no evidence of anyone before Jesus using this term to address God. When it came to prayer, Jesus was a true revolutionary. So happily, we can call the God whom we pray to Father. Now, it is true that God is also the mighty sovereign of the universe. He's the one who created, who governs, and will judge all things. But he is also to us a Father. Yet, we remember what kind of Father he is. He is our Father, but he is our Father in heaven. When we say in heaven, we remember God's holiness and glory. He's our Father, but he's our Father in heaven. We also notice that this is a prayer focused on community. Jesus said, our Father, and not my Father. There's no reference to I, or me, or my in this prayer. The individual comes into the Father's presence, but then he prays as one member of a great family. After the opening address, the model prayer continued, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. You see, the right kind of prayer has a passion for God's glory and plan, for his name, for his kingdom. All of those things have the top priority. By instinct, each one of us wants to guard our own name and our own reputation, but we must resist the tendency to protect and promote ourselves first. And instead, we must put first God's name, God's kingdom, and God's will. Jesus wanted us to pray with the desire that God's will would be done on earth as it is in heaven. You see, in heaven, there's no disobedience. There's no obstacles to God's will. On earth, there is disobedience, and there are apparent obstacles to God's will. The citizens of Jesus' kingdom want to see his will done as freely on earth as it is done in heaven. So today, learn from this model prayer, and let your prayer be, change me, Lord, where I don't understand or accept your will. Lord, let your will be done in me.